So this is the second example in a series of examples where we're solving systems of linear equations. The problem we're going to look at in this example is very similar to what we saw in part A. These equations look the same, but we've made a slight change here in this third equation. So the goal is still the same. We're going to solve this system of equations using kind of row operations and manipulating an augmented matrix into a final form that's easy to solve. So our strategy is the same, but this particular system of equations is a little bit different than the system of equations we saw in the first example, and we'll see what happens. So we'll go ahead and follow the same strategy. We'll form what we call the augmented matrix. We saw how to do that in the first video. We basically just take all the coefficients of x1, x2, and x3 and put them here. And then this final column is the column for the right side of the equal sign. So 2, 3, and negative 4 go right here. So this is what we call the augmented matrix. And now we'll use row operations to manipulate this matrix into a form that essentially has ones and zeros in it as much as possible. Ideally, we'd like to get it down to what we call a reduced row echelon form matrix. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to interchange equations 1 and 2. We're just going to change the ordering. So this 1 right here, I would like that to sit right here. I want to start getting 1s followed by zeros beneath it. So the easy way to get a 1 up top is just to interchange equation 1 and 2. So I'll just interchange those. So I haven't changed anything else except flipping those two rows. And then to get some zeros underneath the 1 in that first column, I can let equation 2 be equal to 4e1 plus e2. That essentially cancels out this negative 4. And then if I let the third equation equal 3 times the first equation plus the third equation, that essentially adds 3 to negative 3 and gets a 0 there. So after I do that, I end up with this system of equations. We're going a little bit faster here because these were very similar to what we did in the first video. So I kind of like this. I have 1 followed by zeros beneath it. Now what I would like to do is start getting a 1 here with zeros underneath that. So the next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to let e3 equal e3 minus e2. So that's going to cancel out this negative 1 here. So equations 1 and 2 don't change, but equation 3, I subtract minus 1 minus minus 1. This gives me a 0, and then 2 minus 2 gives me a 0. And then 5 minus 14 gives me a negative 9. Okay, so I've gotten some zeros down here that I like. At this point, though, something interesting has happened. If we look at this equation right here, I have a whole bunch of zeros on the left and then a negative 9 on the right. If we actually write out what this equation is saying, it's saying that 0 times x1 plus 0 times x2 plus 0 times x3 equals a negative 9. So this is what that bottom equation means if we actually write it all out. Well, 0 times x1 plus 0 times x2 plus 0 times x3 is obviously 0. So this equation is really saying that 0 is equal to a negative 9. Well, that is obviously not true. 0 is not equal to a negative 9. That's kind of nonsense. Well, in mathematics, we call that a contradiction. So we've actually encountered a contradiction as we've been doing our row operations to reduce the augmented matrix into a form that lets us easily see the solution. At this point, we've encountered a contradiction, something that doesn't make sense. 0 equals to negative 9 doesn't make sense. What that means is that this system of equations does not have a solution. It has no solution. Another way of saying that is that this system of equations is inconsistent. So in the first example we looked at that was very similar to this, we ended up with a single unique solution. We found an x1, x2, and x3 that satisfied the provided system of equations. In this part, in part B, we've looked at a very similar system of equations. We changed that third equation just ever so slightly, and that change has resulted in a system of equations that has a contradiction in it, which means that the system does not have a solution. So sometimes this is the answer. Somebody says solve the system of equations. Sometimes you say there is no solution. The system of equations is inconsistent. So that wraps up this video. In the final video, the next video will work a very similar system of equations again, but it will turn out that this final example we look at not only has one solution, but has an infinite number of solutions, has a whole family of solutions that solve the equations. So we'll do that next.